What's up, everyone? Today I'm looking at the Fat Company 1:8 scale Matoi Ryuko from the anime Kill la Kill. So this is my first time reviewing a posed figure. Cause that, I'm not exactly sure how to go about this. So this time I'm gonna do away with my normal procedure and just go with it. So first off, let's take a look at the box, and it is awesome. It is designed to look like Senketsu. Here's his teeth up here, so it's all inside of his mouth. And up here on the top of the box is his eye and his scar. So that looks pretty damn cool. On the side of the box is one of those, I don't know what you'd call them, those shiny things, these things here. Stars or flashes or whatever. And this side just says Kill la Kill Ryuko Matoi Kamui Senketsu version, so. And on the back here is a couple of pictures of the figure from the front and from the back. So that's enough about the box. Let's bust this thing open and see what we got. So here's the inner packaging, and you can see the figure itself here. The scissor blade over here looking amazing. I can already see the paintwork on that. Looks so good. Moving down a bit here, we have an alternate hand, the big long version of the scissor blade, as well as the base down here. Moving it around to the back, and there's nothing extra back here, but it all looks amazing so far. Let's get it out here and see what it's like. Also in here, some instructions showing the included parts, the base over here, some extra parts of the base, and around on the other side, how to put everything together, the scissor blade, how to attach it into her hand, and there's a section here that comes out of the base. I'm not sure what that's for yet, but I will check that out later on. So here she is out of the box, and this figure looks absolutely amazing. One thing that caught me off guard first is that it's a lot smaller than I thought it would have been. This is a 1:8 scale figure, so I didn't expect it to be that big, but it is, as you can see, very, very small. Here it is next to a Figma. Here it is next to the Ryuko Nendoroid. Next to another 1:8 scale figure. And here it is next to a 1/6 scale figure. If all that means nothing to you, here it is next to a can of beer. But besides the height, this is an amazing looking figure. And as you can see, most of what's going on is going on from a lower viewing angle. If you're looking at it from a normal perspective like this, you don't really see a whole lot going on. You really have to be checking it out from a lower angle like this. So you're really gonna have to keep that in mind when displaying this, but that's still cool. All that stuff, I guess, is kind of irrelevant. Let's get on to what's important. How does this thing look? As you've probably noticed by now, it looks absolutely fantastic. Paintwork on this is amazing. I can't see any paint out of line anywhere. As you can see, the face looks amazing. Especially the eyes, they really stand out. All the lines here are perfect on the mouth there and on the eyes. It just looks great. As for the hair, that looks amazing as well. The little red stripe in the front here, not as cool looking as the Nendoroid, but still amazing nonetheless. These little metallic horns up here as well in a nice metallic paint really contrasts against the kind of matte of the hair up here. Also, a little bit of red detailing in there as well. The spikes on the hair look fantastic as well. A little bit of a mold line here, but that's no real big deal. I'd prefer not to see that, but it's still not so bad. Moving around to the back here, and you can see the red on the underside of the hair there as well. That looks very nice. Not to be too easy to see on the camera here, but there is some highlighting on the hair in a kind of lighter gray. From all angles, the head on this figure looks fantastic. Moving down a bit now, and we've got Senketsu. The eye here looking amazing with its red, yellow, dark red, orange, and yellow in here. The detailing on here is particularly nice. Moving around here now to the other eye, and that looks amazing with that scar there, as well as some red under here in these indents. So also some nice red lines on the back of the eyes here and over here as well. A nice, really well executed red line here on the sailor uniform style part here. Underneath that there, you can see that awesome jet engine style vent here in the back. That looks so good, as well as a little metallic looking section here attaching to this strap. On the arms here, they're highlighted in a similar fashion to the hair in this kind of light gray. Some real attention to detail here on the inner palms. It is red, as well as on the nails here. Some really nice fine detail. This other hand over here that can rotate around and can be removed, and I will get to that later. But as you can see, some nice sculpting in here on the palm of the hand as well. The pose this figure is in is amazing. And probably the best aspect of it is the position the legs are in. It actually looks like she is going to swing that sword around with some fierce power. So that's pretty cool. Just like I pointed out on the back, there's a metallic clip here attaching to the straps, and the same color as well on these spikes or teeth on the skirt down here as well. The amazing detail carries on down to the legs as well, and you can see that the red here, just like before, is pretty much perfectly executed. The sculpt as well is amazing, some folds here as well as some nice detail on the back of the heels over here. And again, just demonstrating their attention to detail here, they've even sculpted the sole of the shoe down here as well. And the last thing to look at is the base. Personally, I think the bases on posed figures are very important. Some figures come with just like a clear plastic or just like plain black plastic base, and I really don't think that cuts it. But here, it's a pretty nice base. It's nothing amazing, there's not really a whole lot going on here, but it does complement the figure really well. It's got a really cool smashed rock look to it, and there's some nice paintwork down here as well. Also included in here is this small little section from the base for supporting her knee. This section of the base here can be removed, and this can be replaced in there. Not exactly sure what the point is, because I find that it really isn't all that needed. So now I'm going to stick the blade in so you can see what it looks like with that attached. So to attach that, the handle just sticks in there, and the blade just attaches on like so. And there's what it looks like with the blade attached. Also included in the box are the parts over here for displaying Ryuko with the scissor blades in decapitation mode. So to attach them, you basically just remove this hand, attach this one, connect this center segment into both hands. This bottom part attaches on here like so, and then this huge blade attaches in the top like this. And there is Ryuko with her sword in decapitation mode. And as you can see, that looks pretty damn awesome. So that is it for my review. So this was the 1/8 scale Ryuko by Fat Company, and I have to say, it is an amazing figure. The sculpt, the paint, the detail, everything is amazing, and it just looks great. I have to admit, I was a bit surprised by the size at first. It is a bit on the small size for the price range, but besides that, it is pretty awesome. This is one though that you're gonna have to store on a high shelf, because you don't see much from a dead on or a high angle. So that's it. This was my first posed figure review, so I would like to know what you thought. Would you like to see more of these in future? If you would, let me know. So thank you very much everyone for watching, and make sure to come back for more anime figure reviews.